similar?
Well, basically to test the...
Yeah,
we are going to have a chart where we want to essentially test the new building in an active environment that completely mimics the real environment, so thousands and thousands of players online. You can't really run. And then we'll probably do that, because then you might miss important bugs before you go live to millions of people. That would really...
And sort of on the same topic, we actually got a couple of questions from guilds that are in our council. This one in particular condemned, really had a couple of questions on their mind. And on the same line of that, I guess leading up to launch and post-launch, we in previous MMOs, there have been raid content that has been directly compacted towards guilds, and guilds would be brought in to test their alpha or something like that of their raids, or even bring them in and test a specific raid content. Do you have any plans to do that, where you would bring in guilds to actually test the elder content, such as raids?
I think so. That's something that Gabe, leading up the development of our operations at Flash Points, and that's a strategy he definitely wants to use for testing, because it's good to keep a little bit of surprise about what's coming out, so you want to get some experts to test it out and make sure that that's a smaller portion of the audience, because the bigger portion of the audience you have testing, the more likely all the secrets get spilled out before you actually launch the new Google content.
Cool. And also in terms of raids, Gabe also talked a little bit about the loot distribution, how you get a sack or like a satchel. We're wondering if essentially in harder modes, would that sort of loot distribution differ? Would it be the same system, or would there be loot drops in that?
For example, hard mode of a load on Flashpoint is going to have different loot than that range. Otherwise, you'd be getting loot for 20 or 20 hours when you're doing one of Flashpoints that was originally there for, say, level 24 characters. We don't want to be getting loot to, like, in hard mode, you're going to be getting loot for level 50 characters. So that would be a lot different. We're also putting in the ability for the utility to actually distribute loot. We know that that's very important for a lot of without that, and we'll have lots of time.
Cool, thanks.
You might be able to talk a little bit about the recent event. I don't even know the event. We confirmed that achievements did make it in for ship. Is there any more you can say about that right now?
Okay, is this working, by the way?
Yep.
But you're not going to hear it here. It's not there for sure. So achievements. We do have achievements in Star Wars: The Old Republic, and you should be seeing it in the next build. Right now, we're limited really to only a few types of achievements, but it's something that we can easily expand, and we are going to expand. It's just something that we wanted to get the system in without the ship, but it wasn't high priority on expanding it out to have it, be the be-all, end-all achievements, because we felt that achievements is something that you becomes very important in the end game when you basically played your character all the way to level 50 and you're looking for other activities. So it's something that is definitely expandable.
Cool. Thanks.
Hi, James. My name's Tom from Tour Talk. I was just wondering, is there going to be some type of guild event system or cameras that are implemented into the game to sort of help guilds sort of organize with their operations, weapons, and all other events?
We definitely want to put something like that in the game. For ship, we're not going to have it in the game. We are looking at ways to implement this, and like something we could also do on the website. We look at it a bunch of things, but I can't say we're not going to have an in-game sponsorship, but it's high on the priority list.
Thank you.
Hi, James. This is Justin from fragworld.org, and I'm just curious if for Elder Game that you really talked about, the open world PvP element, everything like that, how is that going to be now? And servers where there's possibly imbalance of play.
Well, a lot of thought has gone into design. 2005. I should probably just defer to him talking about it until we able to give you more detailed answers than I could in terms of the exact development design and responding to making sure the population is balanced and sure don't get back. But we have been testing how you all with small groups of players, so 10, 20 players, and then we can also scale up to many, many more players.
Cool. And how afraid is Stephen Reed of you being on Twitter?
That is a little bit worried. He was concerned. I mean, he came into my office because I talked to Neil first, and he was like, yeah, you can go on Twitter, so I went on Twitter, and he said, what the hell, you're on Twitter?
Cool, thank you.